Sunsama dropped a Notion integration, so I'm going to break it down because I literally talk about Notion every 5 minutes on this channel. So if you go into your Sunsama workspace and press Shift N, you'll actually get to see the Notion integration. So if we press add Notion to this, what you're going to basically have is the opportunity to select certain pages. So if I select something like, I'm going to do tasks/events, which is a database I have, then check this guy, it's added in here. And then if I press allow access, you'll be prompted with a guide that shows, okay, you've successfully added Notion. Here's what to expect. Browse your tables and Kanbans, not your pages. So plain text pages can't be turned into tasks, but anything in a database can be. That's important. That's why I selected a database. So we go next, import tasks you want to work on into Sunsama. Okay. So if I go into task/events, it by default will sort by the created time from what I can tell, because I had an idea to like increase my car payments to get the principal paid off quicker. So first of all, I'm going to filter it by time is, and this is cool because it actually has like similar Notion filtering. As you can see, this is like really what Notion has. So filter is, let's say within the next week, and then you can do something else. So I want to make sure it's assigned to me. This integration, as can be seen by what I'm trying to show you, has a complete functionality with the properties that are within Notion. This is crazy. So then I'm gonna sort it by the time that I put. And then just for a further point, I'm gonna actually change it to where time is today. So you can see that my daily planner situation that I had going on in Notion with this is the same. So if we look at these different things here, you actually have the exact same ones going on. So what are the benefits to this type of situation? You can combine things like your ideas that you were to have in a capture inbox circumstance in Notion into here and drag them like so onto the tasks area, just like maybe you would have in other daily planner apps. Once you go into this integration, you can add or remove different pages to this integration by going to this process. And basically what you have to do is say, I want to add my habit tracker. What I'm going to go and do is go to my habit tracker in Notion, find this database, open it, press share. Then I'm going to invite Sunsama as it is already integrated with the application itself. So you can go back to Sunsama and I then refresh Sunsama to get the update of what I just did. And it's loading the different Notion databases. And you'll see here as I can type habit tracker, it'll show up. Now I want you to ignore all this B-roll list thing. This is an issue I've been having in my Notion for a while. I just haven't done some cleanup. So my apologies for that. But if I type habit tracker, I now have the ability to see the habits that are in there. So if I once again go and filter it so that the status is unchecked and the time is today. And then if I even wanted to see the status of whether it's checked off or not, I have a little bit of a habit tracker situation going on here. So the reason that this is a decent thing to do is because many of us have systems in Notion where their entire ecosystem is based on it. As I have a Notion daily planner that is completely set up on my phone, on my computer, and to be frank, a lot of the task management that you have in Notion isn't perfect. So obviously there is a Google Calendar integration. So if I press on this, we have a Google Calendar that is synced with Sunsama, which is nice. And other applications like Notion aren't built to have these easy integrations. So my whole thing is this, if you are using your email, like on Gmail, and you want to be able to interact with Sunsama consistently and kind of not have to deal with going through different inboxes and whatnot or different applications, you can leverage the fact that maybe you have a friend like me who loves Notion as and is assigning tasks to you, but you can keep your daily tasks figured out by sort of going through all of your different integrations and dragging those things there and having it filtered to just tasks that are assigned to you and maybe today. And then another great thing about this is that the filtering is just as good as you want it to be. So I can get rid of this and change it to add filter group, just like you can in Notion, and add filter group where assigned to is me and status is unchecked. So that even anything that would already be done wouldn't showcase here. And then you can also do grouping just like you can in Notion. You can also showcase the different properties in here, just like I think is pretty interesting. The fact that I could showcase the times that I had assigned to this, which is unlike any integration we've ever seen with the Daily Planner app in Notion. None of them have been able to do the filtering and the group functionality even that you have in Notion. I can group it by task and event type. There's an ad hoc task, there's a root task. This is the most incredible integration that has ever happened with Notion, bar none. They've actually allowed you to integrate the application. This is the true meaning of integration. You can do the same filtering, the same sorting, the same grouping, the same showing of properties, all by grabbing a database in Notion. This kind of stuff is incredible when applications come together. But what also would be incredible would be clicking the link down below to sign up for Sunsama today, and by clicking this right here in order to improve your Notion even more.